If somebody's screwing with you, which is a good sign, they're trying to throw you off the scent before you're asking questions, and they aren't used to people in this town asking questions. You kicked their hornet's nest, and they're pissed off.
I leaned away from O'Brien, and I whispered the Stutz part into the phone. Roger. I was attacked. People are dead.
Really?
You didn't sound all that impressed.
Well, we're definitely going to have to talk about that later. For now, though, I found something in Vanessa's file that we need to discuss. You got a gun,
Lord, have mercy.
We've been dating for 6 months. It would only take an idiot to not notice the trend. Even if it had only been 2 times. I rushed to the library the second I realized it, and piled possibly every book over 500 pages into my bag. At my dorm, I flipped through them at page 413. Each book was normal, though. No poem to improve my life. No wonderful 4 lines. Maybe I had been wrong. Or maybe it was because I hadn't read the whole book. I took all the books back to the library, checked out the 5th Harry Potter book. My hands trembled on page 411. I let my whole body shake on page 412. And on page 413, like I knew it would be, was my prize. The poem told me I was a singer. At first this was laughable, as I literally made a tortured cat sound like an angel. But sure enough, Laurie had called me the next day, asking why I wasn't at my concert in the school auditorium. Nerve-wracking at first? Yes. But the second I forced myself onto the stage that night, my voice was Sia on steroids. Apparently, I even had a record deal with a minor music company. But of course, I did. I've been a singer my whole life. A box away. Or possibly, I came to that conclusion myself. Just stopped on my own. Either way, I stopped exchanging notes with Bella and lost track of the box. That was decades ago. I hadn't thought about the box or my childhood friend Bella in years. But last weekend, I was cleaning out my parents' attic and came across a little wooden music box tucked away in a dusty plastic crate. My eyes lit up when I saw it. Memories came flooding back. I may have been lonely and weird as a child, but I always enjoyed my imaginary pen pal. I blew the dust off of the box, ran my fingers over the complicated knotwork carvings, remembering secrets shared and problems solved. With a grin,
fuck!
I opened the lid and see what was inside.
Oh, you sweetie, my mother cooed. What's gotten into you? Who are you, and where did you take my real son? She said, laughing.
Oh, wow.
Cool, just now
black.
Really?
Yeah.
Black with
one
eyeballs.
One equals black with eye bobs. Okay.
Let's look up her skirt. Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa! Too mature!
Too spoopy for you.
There you go.
Oh my gosh. Alright.